Hello, people. Welcome to another edition of your program, Sports Dialogue, on this channel. The channel is ASEN TV. It means African Sports Entertainment and News Network. My name is Jide Olaniran. It's good to be here once again. And today promises to be an exciting time as we'll be looking at another important issue as far as sport is concerned. We'll go on a short break, and when we come back, it will be time for me to let some of those things out of my bag of goodies. Welcome back. It's Sports Dialogue, and I'm your host, Jide Olaniran. Just of recent, Nigeria boxing, I beg your pardon, was in the news talking about Nigeria's Anthony Joshua, who won the heavyweight championship title. Yeah, talking about boxing heavyweight championship title. The story about his roots. Is he a Nigerian? Is he a British? These are some of the things that have been in the news in recent time. And we've been looking at what is the future of Nigerian boxing. This particular achievement for Joshua has brought to the fore once again, what is Nigeria doing about boxing? And I will be talking to an expert, somebody who you know is a coach, a boxing coach that is, and also a Commonwealth champion. He's also been whipped into the controversy that's been trailing the roots of what happened to Joshua. That's when he came to Nigeria. These are some of the things that we'll be looking at as far as this issue is concerned. You can join me and let's roll together. And also, I have another friend in the house who will be looking at some of these issues vis-a-vis from the perspective of Obisi Awankpa. Yes, I've let the cat out of the bag already. The person I have on the line with me to talk about the issue of boxing and the future of this squared rope game in Nigeria is Obisi Awankpa, a former Commonwealth boxing champion. And of course, he is still in the game. He is trying to discover talent as well as nurture some of them to grow to become champions. Welcome once again and straight to the business of the day. We'll go straight to Obisi Awankpa. Thank you very much, Obisi Awankpa. Thanks for joining us on the show. The first question I have for you is that, is there any benefit when an athlete represents his or her country, especially if you are a Nigerian? Obisia, Nigerians born here or abroad, you know, they have changed allegiance to represent other countries. Other countries, of course, one in question of recent is the issue of Joshua. And what do you think is the cause of this? Okay. Football seems to attract the attention of people in government in Nigeria to the detriment of other sports like boxing. But what is it like? Why is it that seems to be the order of the day? just of recent, Anthony Joshua here, the man of the moment, just won a world title. And the question is, do you think he could have won the title if he was resident in Nigeria? Okay, is professional boxing in Nigeria taking advantage of its affiliation to governing bodies, world governing bodies like the IBF, WBO, WBC, and WBA? I'm going to go to the next one. Okay, homegrown boxers are not known because we don't see them on television. Don't you think the media needs to really support boxing also? Because if they can come in, that can also help talking about the fortune of that sport. All right. What is the kind of support you expect from government as regards sports and, by extension, boxing? There are concerns about the politics of sports, which is what a lot of people don't get to see. Is Nigeria playing the politics well? There are lots of young people who want to emulate Anthony Joshua. They want to become future champions, especially in Nigeria. Is there hope on the horizon for them in Nigeria at all? Thank you very much, Obisia, for joining us on the show. All right, from Obisia right now, I will move to another person who will be giving me some insights into some of the issues that Obisia has spoken about. I have Joachim Idada joining me once again on the show. Joachim, it's good to have you join me again, making another round of appearance on the show.
My pleasure, as usual, Jimmy.
All right. Obisia just spoke to us and he said something about the fact that lots of things are wrong with Nigeria, especially sports by extension. We have to stay where his expertise is, where he knows his onions. That's talking about boxing. He said that there are no genuine sport administrators in the country, that nothing is done about sports development, talent discovery, management, and exposure. You agree with me? We agree with him.
I agree with him to an extent.
Okay.
Okay. In the technical areas of any sport, you need some level of expertise as regarding the issues related to that sport. But in managing sports in general, you do not need such technical intent. What you need is your capacity to manage human resource and to deploy assets to achieve set goals and objectives. That is where the problem is in Nigeria. The problem is, when it comes to sports, do we really have a set goal and objective? When you appoint someone as the Minister of Sports, or you appoint somebody as the Director of Sports Development, or as anything, what are the mandates? What are his targets? What have you told him or the yardsticks that you are going to measure his success or failure?
Okay.
You also ask yourself, the person coming on board or the person giving the assignment, what is his vision? Because what we have today are just, I don't know, without just saying, we are just running around in circles.
Okay.
And I don't know how far to take us.
All right. He's also said something about the fact that it was good that he was able to also open up as regards the issue of Anthony Joshua.
Yeah.
Said he's never met Anthony Joshua. He never came to Nigeria. But that's not the side of the story that is making rounds.
I don't know why the noise. I don't know why the Bua. I don't know why the Hula Balu. I don't know why, before I start talking like But look, like he said, we are not invested in quote, we are not invested in creating the product. Why do we want to claim it? Is it just because he has a Nigerian parenting? Today, parenting has gone beyond just being father and mother. You need to pay the dues. You need to do what it takes to groom. You first of all discover the talent. After you discover the talent, you groom the talent. You expose the talent. Before you can now come out and say you want to derive the benefit from the talent, then the question I ask, what have we done concerning not only Anthony Joshua, concerning almost all the sports, in every sport we have in Nigeria, what have we done concerning the athletes of those sports? That today we cannot beat our chest and say we deserve that, we're entitled, you know what they call it, the bragging rights.
Okay.
That we want the bragging rights. On what basis are you asking for the bragging rights? I don't understand. I think Nigerians need to be educated about that kind of a thing. That, look, the world has become a global village. If you do not appreciate what you have, those who appreciate who know what they want, they know how to go after it. And when they get it, you cannot begin to cry. Woof, when you didn't pay the price to produce the product.
It seems like it's been gradually becoming like a rocket science is needed to develop sports in this country, because most times stories like that of Joshua keeps repeating, they keep reoccurring
almost in
every sport. And you ask yourself, we are back at it again. How do we help the situation? Because we must get serious.
We need to go back to the grassroots. When it was happening for Nigeria, what were we doing then that was right, that today we have failed? One of the things we were doing then was the sport, the emphasis we put on school sports. In those days, we never used phone.
Mm-hmm.
All of those, today, go check. We don't have any sports in the schools. When you do not have sports in the schools, how do you discover talents? And the earlier you discover them, the better for you. Because if you discover a talent at the age of, let me ask you, at the age of 12, you begin to groom the talent. You invest in the talent. How many schools in Nigeria offer scholarship to sportsmen? How many schools in Nigeria even understand what it is to invest in sports? How many schools in Nigeria have coaches for their different sports?
Even do they allow sporting activities?
Yes. I remember when I was in university, I had a professor, even though I read engineering, a professor of numeric analysis. His name was Professor Ifemoku. Very smart man, and an engineer. But you see, he had a black belt in karate. And I remember then in school, he would always tell me, university is not just come and read your book. Get to do other things. Get to take part in sports. Get involved. Go do some things. But today, how many schools in Nigeria will allow an athlete adjust his timetable so that he can go and participate in one sporting event and they will let him come back and sit for his exam at a later time? You see, everything is in crisis. NCAA, I always tell people, NCAA, that's not the National College Athletic Association, is our equivalent of NUGA. Tell me, go to the internet and Google how much the NCAA makes annually in income. And part of this income is even shared amongst the schools. But if you come to Nigeria, NUGA annual always goes cap in hand to government. Oh, we want to hold NUGA games. Government should come and give us money. Everything government. I do not understand. Sincerely, I don't understand.
Is that why it appears it's only the government that wants to acknowledge the feat achieved by Anthony Joshua? Because it's only the government that wants to do a welcome reception.
On what basis? On what basis?
After him or not?
On what basis are they trying to throw a party to celebrate what? I don't understand.
That somebody who has a Nigerian blood just achieved, just became a world championship. Don't forget that.
What did once, you do to produce him?
Don't forget that there was one Samuel Peters. We had Samuel Peters. Where is he? And what?
Well, that's the point. Where is Samuel Peters? Well, see, first of all, we need to pay the bills. If you do not pay the bills, forget it.
How do we get? Because most times, when we start the discussion at a larger forum, you hear funding. What are those things that are being done, for instance, in the United States, where you have the NCAA, or that we need to maybe kind of copy and make it work here? Because
the media plays a prominent role in sports. Without media, everything you do in sports becomes a mere activity. It just becomes a mere activity. And so that is where the challenge is. So those who own media must begin to reappraise their strategy. Sports is business. It's not just fun. Sports is business. And do you know how much there's a media house in Nigeria who today, I don't want to call their name, who today says they cannot, in quotes, sponsor or continue, they cannot continue to show our NPFL. Right. But they want to show UEFA. They want to show Premier League. And those two events It is not free. They bought the right.
Yeah.
They paid a lot of money for the right. I asked the question, do they have a tree at the back of their company? No. It's the subscription of Nigerians that they've used to go and buy their right. Meanwhile, you tell us, Nigerians, that, oh no, we sorry, we cannot show FPFL, cannot show our Premier League. You show there's something wrong. It's not only about government. Nigerians should blacklist them with immediate effect. But I want to watch EPL. Oh, I want to watch this. If you ask an average Nigerian, even the so-called soccer fan, how much do they even understand about Nigerian football? Nothing. Everybody just seems not to be interested. Everybody just feels that it's a lost case in Nigeria. But I don't agree. I don't agree. The media must play its role. Rule number one. If you go to America, there is a media organization called Pac-12.
Okay.
All they show is college sports. Nothing Premier, nothing NBA, just college sports. Why can't we have that kind of media? But if you go to Nougat and tell Nougat that you want to partner with them to promote
what they have.
University sports, the first thing they'll tell you is, oh, go and bring 130 million. Go and, everything here, go and bring money. Go and bring money. Meanwhile, the product has not been developed. Then we have to now also improve our competence in the area of sports administration and marketing. It goes beyond just going to NIS or going to one university to go and reach physical education. It requires, if we need to send people abroad, to go and understand other systems. In Europe, things are working. In America, things are working. Why don't we have people understanding? And finally, we need to do everything to bring back sports into our school's curriculum. It is compulsory. Without that, there is no way.
Are you saying we're not doing enough now with what a lot
it's enough.
Enough. People trying to
enough.
Youth games.
We're not doing anything.
States trying to, yeah. They are trying, they would say.
We are not doing anything. Let me ask a question. Let the people in the Ministry of Sports and the Ministry of Education come and tell us how many hours per week do the children in the school get involved in sports? How many of those schools have coaches? What we have are PE teachers doubling as coach. I don't understand.
No.
How many sports will a physical education teacher be able to teach? We have close to 100 and something sports. So the PE teacher can just teach, he can do exercise, that I agree. He can teach the children to run around, just jog. But when it comes to coaching, as in coaching, if the government does not ask people or parents to pay to have physics teacher, English teacher, mathematics teacher, why then should we say that the PTA or the parents should pay to get coaches to come and coach the children? The way you are employing physics teachers, English teachers, chemistry, that's the same way you should employ coaches. Coaches to come and coach in the schools. And with that, we have started. If you go to all the other climes, that is what you see they do. There's a lot of work to be done.
Well, all right. Chris, I think this is where we'll have to drop the anchor on today's show. It's been nice talking to Obisi Anwankwa, coach of the national team as well as former Commonwealth champion who joined us earlier. And Joaquin, thank you very much for your insight into this particular issue. With the dialogue will definitely continue because we will push it out and make sure that there are lots of things, changes are made as far as Nigerian sport is concerned. Thank you very much once again for joining me on this special edition. Every edition is special, but this is another special one that we've been able to deliver. I'm yours truly in sports. Gideon Lanner is my name. Thanks for joining me. See you another time on Ascent TV.